Beauty Con LA this morning. I'm excited to introduce the panel that's going to be sitting here, but I want to tell you guys a little something here. I am Latina, I am a brown woman, I am very proud of my identity, and it's really exciting to see a brand like Beauty Con understanding that and seeing the value, because you know, when you look around, you can see so much diversity. And I always say, if you really want to know what this country looks like, you have to come to LA. You know, because the city is a melting pot. And that's what makes us special, you know, the love that we have for each other despite our differences. It's all about understanding and accepting that your neighbor has maybe a different culture, even sometimes even a different language. And I'm excited that today we're going to be talking about all of that, because as women and men in positions where we're here on this stage, and we're people of color, black and brown, it is a responsibility that we have and that we carry for our children. So then in return, when they become adults, they're the ones creating the change that we're so desperately needing in this country. So with that said, I'm gonna introduce the incredible panel from the Rivera Dynasty, our favorite television superstar, global speaker, and CEO of Jenny Rivera Enterprises. Get up for Rosy Rivera.
Hello, everyone. Beauty Con. Love to see you guys.
So gorgeous.
Thank you. You too. I love your outfit.
And CEO and founder of Be Bella Cosmetics and Beauty Creations, just total chingona, Esmeralda Hernandez. I'm fully charged, nipples
are hot, ready to go. I'm sweating from head to toe. Thank you, I'm so excited. Oh my goodness. Thank you guys for being here.
Last but never least, our favorite YouTuber, entrepreneur, and story time favorite, Luis Castro.
You're so cute. I love your outfit.
Casi me trompezo, me va.
Nos sentamos.
Luis, that makes me so happy.
I'm over here all trompezando.
Do they have a nickname? Are they called the Luis? The
perras or the stupidas?
Okay. Las perras o las estúpidas?
Yes.
Okay, I love how you're reclaiming that word, because before it used to be bad to say that to someone, right?
It's not bad. That's how we use it.
Yeah.
Serving a little perra look today.
Yes. Perra y perrísima.
Yes.
Vamos a ir a perrear after that.
Right after this.
I love that word. Vamos a ir a perrear. Well, I'm really happy to be here and excited to be here with all you incredible Latinx human beings, just influencers, leaders, really doing and just holding it down for our community. And we were talking backstage about, you know, the things that we should do, and as, you know, when we're here on this stage, because it never really happens.
Yeah.
You know, when you see a brown or black person on a stage, it's something that you don't see. And it's really important, especially for our children and young kids, adults, to see that type of representation. And I wanted to start off by talking about the challenges that we face, because some people may say, well, you're already at a level of success. You don't have challenges. What do you know, you know? But there are still challenges. We're still fighting the system.
Yeah,
we're
seriously.
Still every single day working toward change, and not just for ourselves. We're talking about it for everybody, right?
Exactly.
So like, let's talk about those challenges, Rosy.
Well, for us, for my family, there was poverty challenges. My parents were immigrants that came from Mexico. My dad had 60 cents in his pocket, and he just wanted to feed us. So he would tell us, I gotta feed you guys. We never planned on being superstars, or my family. We never planned on singing. To be honest, we didn't even think we were talented. My dad just said, I gotta feed my kids. And there was hostility So he had to sell oranges on the side of the road.
You do what you gotta do.
And we went to the swamp meet. We went to El Tianguis. And he said, if we gotta sell diapers, we're gonna sell diapers. And I'm just so glad that he showed us that work ethic. And what he taught us is work hard, don't step on anybody, and you're gonna get where you're, you be the best at what you do. And thank God that created the Rivera family for us.
And Esmeralda.
Hey guys, well, I'm gonna talk to you as a business perspective. It's hard because they see you as a Latina and you're going into this business where it's only, you know, other ethics, and it's so hard. They don't take you seriously. I remember the first time that I walked into a Korean store and I was like, hey, you know, I'm selling my products. They were like, do you have an invoice? They thought the products were stolen. So it's really, really hard. It's so hard to them. You know, I feel like it's just the way they think, you know? But it was super hard. And people think like, oh my God, you're just so lucky. No, I'm not lucky. I work for it.
Yeah.
And I still have a lot of struggles. There's days that I'm like, oh my God, I don't want to do it anymore. Like, I'd rather go back to the Swami because we had similar beginnings. I started from the Swami. I'm Mexican, so I came to this country when I was 9 years old. I didn't know the language. So it was really hard. And people now see it like, oh, you're just lucky. No, it took a lot of years.
Yeah, it's not luck.
It's not luck. It, of course, it's not luck.
Louis.
Yeah, no. Hi, guys.
Woo!
I can definitely relate to both of you. It's the same thing. My family came to the United States with nothing in their pockets. They came here to give me and my sisters a better life. And it's just, even talking about it makes me so sad, like knowing everything that my parents went through. Like, girl, me puedo poner a llorar. And it's just like, you know, it's so hard, like the struggle and everything that our parents did for us. And, you know, even like what I'm doing right now, I am so thankful for it. And it's all thanks to you guys. First, like, I'm so thankful for it. And it gives us like a platform to, you know, talk about these things, which is like something that is not really talked about so much. So I just want to say thank you guys for giving us this platform. And I'm so happy to be here with all of you too.
I want to talk about, because we're first generation, second generation Americans here. And we kind of have a very similar upbringing. Our parents had to do the bare minimum just to provide the bare necessities,
right.
You know? And we're surrounded, we're in an environment where every family around you is doing the same thing, right? And there's an expectation to just be part of this community and stay there.
Yeah.
What happens to you individually that inside you where you're like, I need to step out of this,
right.
Not just for myself, but for my community? Like, when did that click for you?
I think I realized that I needed to step out for my father and my mother when our own community was destroying us. Because when we first started here, when you first started anything and you're not successful and you're at the same level, people, well, you're in the same struggle. But then you get to a certain point where your own community turns against you. Why? Because you are making it. Because you are different. Because you've decided to dress a little bit different. Or, you know, let's just be upfront. Sometimes we start being jealous of, well, why do you have the nice car? We've both been working at the swamp meet forever. You know, why is she making it? So when I started to see that, I wanted to show my parents that our community was wonderful, but that we could also take it to another level. And I felt that that was my responsibility. My parents paved the way with much sacrifice, tears, even blood, to get to a certain point. And as a second generation, it is my responsibility to go to the next level and bring them with me. So I had to make sure that I brought them with me. And there were challenges of, first of all, don't leave, because sometimes our community doesn't want to let us go.
what you're rejecting, my religion, you're rejecting the way I dress, you're rejecting what I taught you. So I had to let my parents know I don't reject it. I love it. And because I love it, I want to show it to the world. I want to show frijoles, I want to show banda, I want to show my skin color, everything to the rest of the world. And then to the rest of the world outside of the communities, when I was going to college, and they're like, oh, you got here through affirmative action? Well, I got here because I worked hard. I got here because I'm smart. You know, no one gave me this free ticket. So then I also told them, I embrace you, but I also love my past, so you have to accept all of me. And there were challenges because both wanted to reject the transition, but I treaded through because I'm gonna make it happen. Pioneers always have challenges, but you have to continue to tread through because you're gonna make a difference for your past and for your future generations.
Amen. Amen. And Esmeralda, you know, just continuing that, you know, that conversation, do you think you coming from, you know, another country here at a young age, do you think there's, you know, we always say like immigrants and Latinos, like we are just like hard workers, like, and that it's in our blood to have that, like the desire of just doing any whatever it takes to come home and just bring it, you know? Do you see that being part of how you created your, you know, what you've done with Bibella and, you know, and the way you live your life?
For me, I got pregnant when I was 19 and I was like, fuck, sorry. I'm gonna stay here. I'm gonna do the same thing my mom did, that was selling perfumes at the Swami. And I was like, you know what? I think my mom came to this country to give me a better life. And that was when I was like, you know what? I'm gonna change that. And I'm gonna be like, you know what, mom? You're gonna be so proud of me that you're gonna be like, damn, that's my daughter. And I think that's the reason that our parents come to this country. They wanna give us a better life. And us, we have the responsibility to do something better with it, you know? That doesn't mean that our parents are not doing the best thing, but we want to be something better than them because that's the reason they came to this country, to give us a better life.
So if I can interject really quick, what I see in Esmeralda and the reason that we chose her, where Jenny Rivera joined Bibella, was one, because she was a Latina. Because yes, I'd love to go to Mac and Jenny could be with Mac and I'm not saying there's anything wrong with any collaborations, but in my mind, I would rather join with the Latina brand and say, let's go together, let you know. And so we met about 3 years ago, and Esmeralda is a really hard worker, and that's amazing that we have that as a culture, but we have to work hard and also work smart. Let's do both. You know, let's not just work the 18-hour shift, let's also use our brains, and that's where I saw Esmeralda. She took it to another level, went from perfumes to selling makeup to making the makeup, and that's where I think we have to take
it. No, and that's what I wanted to, you know, to shift, because I wanted to know, and I want all of us to kind of talk about, why is it important to support each other? Louis.
Well, I think as Latinos, we always have to stick together, like always. And I love that. Like even my community, like I love being a Latino. And every time, like I was telling you girls earlier, whenever I get to an area and I see there's like more Latinos and Latinas, I myself feel so much more comfortable.
We were just talking about that backstage,
yes,
like, right?
I bring out my Spanish real quick.
Yes,
so you can
me
know,
too.
Like,
I'm
yes.
Like, hey, stupida. Like, no, and it's, I was telling them as well, like it's rare, I want to say. Not super rare, but like a lot of times I'll go to events and I won't see that many Latinos or Latinas. And for a good while, I stopped going to events because I always felt like an outsider. Like I wouldn't, like I couldn't, like I felt like I didn't belong in a way. And
yeah, feel like you're wearing this Target suit and yes. Everyone's looking at you.
Yeah.
And that's something that really happens to, you know, black and brown communities, and, you know, no one else feels that way, is this heaviness that you, mm-hmm. you know, you feel like you're taking up too much space in this, and everyone's just looking at you and you feel uncomfortable and you just feel like, I don't belong here. I'm going to talk and they're going to hear my accent and they're going to think that I'm a foreigner and that I'm not American.
See, well, even like when BeautyCon reached out to us for this, I got so happy for it. And I was like, yes, put me on there. Like, I was like, of course I want to be with some of my fellow Latinas and, you know,
yes.
Do a panel and represent, because where are all my Latinos at? Where are all my Latinas?
Yes.
Yes. This is what I love. Like, I love hearing this, and I'm just so happy that they even give us this opportunity to do this and come together.
And I think as Latinos in general, we have to unite, because sometimes we divide ourselves by, are you Guatemalan, are you Salvadorian, are you Mexican? And it's great to love our culture. You know, it's great to say my mom came from Mexico, but I'm not going to exclude, you know, the Salvadorians. I think when we unite in our nationalities, all Hispanics, all Latinos, all of Southern America, like, let's really unite so that our food, because that's really what it is, some little tweaks in food, some little tweaks in language. Other than that,
we're all the same. We all have the same color skin. We all have the same values and, you know, and the same love. And you know, we're all fighting the same battle here. You know, you're constantly hearing that it's, you know, when you hear our leaders talking about the Mexicans, they're not just talking about the people that live in, you know, that are Mexican American. They're talking about every person that has a brown skin. Yeah. But there's this level of ignorance when they think that everybody that came south of the border is Mexican.
Right.
So don't feel that this is not your battle to fight.
Right.
We're all in this together.
And what's worse is that they know that we're fighting amongst ourselves. So they're like, I don't have to mess with them. They're already killing each other.
Right.
We have to stop that and say, you know what? We may be different in some areas, but our love and our passion and our language unites us more than our differences. And then we're gonna be a force to be reckoned with in this country. We have to be.
And then another thing, I feel like we all come to this country for the same reason, you know? We all want to dream. We all want to live the American dream.
Yes.
So that's the reason that we're here for. Like, let's stop fighting with each other. Let's make, you know, the dreams come true.
And what both of you did, which is, you know, collaborate together, a Latina with Latina, and like you mentioned, you could have gone to any other brand, and they would have taken it in a heartbeat.
Yeah.
But you consciously chose to go with Be Bella because you understood that this wasn't something that was just going to affect you now, but this collaboration here was going to set the tone for generations to come.
Exactly.
So how important is it? I want everybody to know, how important is it for us to spend our dollars within our community?
You have to support small business.
Yes.
Have you guys noticed that our businesses are like going down, small business, Amazon is taking over, and you know, great for Amazon, you know? But the fact that we're losing some of our stores because we are not supporting each other. You know, I wanna give a shout out to the Cuban community, because when you go to Miami, they support each other.
Yeah.
Se levantan en uno al otro, you know? And I see other communities doing it, and I really wish that more Hispanic communities did it. I go to small boutiques and I promote small boutiques. And when I find out it's a woman and a single mom,
even more,
I'm going to buy, because I don't, more than what I look like, I want you to know what I support. And I support small brands. And sure, I'll buy something off of the big brands too, but I'm for sure gonna promote that single mom that left her job to start her dream business. And I think when we joined together, we knew that was my sister's heart. My sister is a great singer and she has great awards, but more than that, Jenny's legacy comes from her character, that our parents taught us. You know, work hard, be honorable, no le robes a nadie, do your best. And I saw that in Esmeralda and Be Bella, two sisters, you know, that support each other, that are fighting for their Mexican-American dream, which is what I call it. I knew that it would motivate others to keep doing it. So I think every step that you take, don't only think of yourself or your family, think of how is this going
to
impact my community
and generations
to
come. And Louis, you are 19 years old.
Yes, almost 20.
Oh yeah, he turns 20 in a week.
August 18.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Like, feliz cumpleaños, feliz.
Where's the pastel? Okay.
You have a very unique perspective because you grew up with social media,
mm-hmm.
right? That's all you knew.
Yeah.
And you're a brown kid.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess for lack of a better word, you are very different than what we're supposed to see in a man, right?
Yes.
And in our community, mm-hmm. we're still very behind, with understanding,
oh, yeah,
and being accepting and loving, mm-hmm, to that.
Yeah.
What were for you, how does social media maybe help you, mm-hmm, to kind of start crafting and directing your own path and be comfortable with yourself and being like, you know what, there's places in my own community where I'm not accepted, but I am accepted here.
Yeah. Well, it's definitely like very, very difficult. Even when I first started, it was something that I wasn't like always 100% myself because I was so scared of doing it.
Your foot here and your foot
back
there.
Yes, like, you know, be like a minority, like being Latino and Mexican and also being like gay. It was just like, it was scary, you know, to do what I wanted to do because I wasn't sure like what it is that I was gonna get back. And you know, there's a lot of machismo. Yeah, machismo, there you go, thank you. Machismo in like the Latin community, and I know.
And for much who also know that machismo is just this
chauvinism,
this identity, yeah, that Latino men carry to portray that, mm, you know, they're strong and that, you know, they're manly and protective.
Right.
And sometimes it goes overboard because it comes down to pride and ego.
Yes.
That's what
yes
it comes down to.
No, and just always being around that just like always made me even more scared because I was like. Like, I was just scared of what I was gonna get. And in my family, it's only me and my two other sisters. So I felt like I was the only other, like, man in the family besides my dad. And it was scary to even think about coming out because I was like, I didn't want to feel like I was letting down my parents, you know? But, well, thankfully, both my parents are super duper duper supportive and I love them with all my heart. And they are also the reason why I do what I do now because they're super supportive. But going on social media and using my platform, like, I just feel like I wanted to be that also, like, an example to my other fellow Latinos to, you know, like, if they wanted to wear makeup. If they want to, like, dress up. Like, anything that they want to do, I felt like me showing that on social media, showing that, you know, it's okay to do it, I feel like was also going to help so many more because I feel like I wasn't seeing a Latino when I was, you know, trying to start makeup. Like, I couldn't find, like, a Latino who was doing it. Then that's
someone that looked like you, that you can identify.
Yes, like, or speaking Spanish, or morenito, right, or anything like that. So even for me, it was, like, scary, because I was scared of what I was gonna get in return from social media itself. And, you know, even where I live, like, I don't really go out in makeup as much, because I still get scared to do it. Not that I'm scared that people are gonna tell me stuff or anything like that. I'm scared of, like, the looks that I get. There were a few times where I would go out with, like, makeup or eyeshadow, and the stares that I would get were just like, absolutely not. I was like, I'm taking this all off. Like, it's just, it's scary, and it's something that I still feel like the Latino community is still, like, learning to accept it. But I'm happy for social media because I feel like it's become so much, it's an easier way for people to see it because it's, with social media, things blow up a lot. And that's
you
how
you can easily find
it.
Your tribe and your
exactly
community.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, on, you know, Louis, I'm so glad that we're on this same panel. When they told me you were going to be here, I knew that it was going to be empowering because your fear is valid. Mm-hmm. I can understand your fear from my nephew, mm-hmm, where he was able to communicate why he couldn't tell us for 2 years, get me, mm-hmm, what he was feeling. We're a Christian family. Mm-hmm. So when I knew, I said, this is going to be the perfect time to let Louis and the world know that not all of us at church would receive you in a bad
yes
way. So I want to say sorry on behalf of the Catholic Church, the Christian Church that has rejected you, that closed the door, that judged you, that probably left a bad comment. We are sorry. Not all of us are like that. And church, we have to change.
And there's room to change.
And there yes is.
And we're like should literally running out of time. Oh. But I mean, we could talk about this sure for hours. But oh, do we have time for questions? We have, okay, I think there's a microphone somewhere around.
And we're ready for something.
We're ready for questions.
Best. Yes, bring it.
I know there's something we could talk about for hours, huh? Maybe what we should do is go backstage and figure
yeah
out ways to continue,
yeah, no,
you know,
sure,
encouraging and supporting, you know, our communities and just giving them the tools to kind of carry this, you know,
yeah,
and become exactly who they see themselves being.
Exactly. Let's be unique in who God
okay
made
so
us.
Okay, so question over there.
Awesome. Well, thank you guys so much for all the words and inspiration that all three beautiful women, all of you guys that you are doing. Thank you so much. I've grown up seeing you guys. And Louis, recently, you know, I've been getting into your videos. So, hola, oh, perra.
You. Yes,
you
know, I love you guys.
Thank you. So what's your question?
My question for you guys is, what inspires you to continue growing, not only as a Latino, but as a person?
Louis?
No, what continues me is just like the support that I get from you guys. Especially, I made a video, How to Dance at Quinceañeras. I feel like that's where I got so much support from my Latino community. Because, you know, the video was like dedicated to my Latinos, like a quinceañera. And that's where I felt so much support, where I was like, girl, I need to keep representing, and I need to keep pushing this
you
out there.
You felt seen.
Yes, I definitely
did. So important.
It was all over, so I was like, I need to keep doing this. Like, I loved the feedback that I got from the community.
Esmeralda, what inspires you?
My mom. Oh. I love seeing her like, oh my God, that's my daughter. So my my family, my kids, my brothers, my family, and as a Latina to be able to represent. So it's wonderful.
Rosie, what wakes you up in the morning?
Knowing that I can impact the world is what motivates me. In my own way, with my characteristics, with my virtues and my defects, knowing that me, this little person from Long Beach, California, that worked at the Swamp Meet, can and will impact the world. And I really believe all of us were put here for that, and we should do it freely.
Great answer. Any other questions? Over here. Hi.
Hey,
hi.
What single piece of advice would you give to a woman of color who's starting out in this space?
Rosie?
Single piece of advice, woman of color, embrace your past. Embrace everything that was done before you with love, because when you embrace it, you portray that to the world where you're going. So if you love yourself, the world will love you too.
Be different, you know. Right now, we're in a world where we're all trying to be, you know.
Okay, well.
We're trying to be something. So I think just be different, be you, and be who you want to be, not who they want to see you.
Exactly. I definitely agree with both of you. Just be yourself and do what you want to do, because I definitely feel like sometimes people feel they have to follow a certain path. And I feel like once you're yourself and you do what you want to do, that's what makes you stand out. So 100%, don't be afraid and just do what you want to do.
And let me add to that. Don't be afraid of fear. You know, fear is there for a reason. Fear is there because your heart is yearning something. And the only thing that's stopping your heart from that is this here. So instead of being afraid of it and stopping yourself because you think you're creating a narrative in your mind or something that hasn't even happened yet, because you're thinking like, oh, you know, it's not going to work out. You don't know that, but your mind's telling you it's not, because your mind was created to protect you from the craziness that your heart leads. So instead of walking in fear, walking with fear here, walk alongside fear and show fear what you're capable of doing.
Yes.
Any other questions? One more question, and we're going to wrap it up. What? Over here.
Hi. So I'm starting YouTube. What would you guys give me, like, for advice as me, like, small to, like, getting bigger as a YouTuber, or as, like,
Louis, you're the king here. La reina aquí. La perra de YouTube. No.
I would definitely say just be yourself. Like I was saying earlier, don't try to follow what you think you need to follow. I say just 100% be yourself, and that's going to make you stand out so much more. And I feel like that's what we like seeing. We like seeing difference. We like seeing different. Because if you try to follow someone else's like shadow and try to be like, you know, something else that you're not happy with, I feel like it's just, you're not being yourself. Once you're 100% yourself, girl, trust me, people are gonna love you for you and what you are doing.
Yes,
and good luck.
And with YouTube, you sometimes worry about the camera and the lighting, and that becomes important, but more important than the lighting and the camera, it's the content.
Yeah.
And you were the content, you were the brand. So be unique and individual and be bold. Whatever gives you passion, speak about that, do that, and then everyone else will love what you love.
Everybody, thank you very much for being here.
Very, very quickly,
one word, American dream. What does that mean to you? One word. Louis.
Hardworking.
Esmeralda.
Family.
Rosie.
Impact.
Love. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Get it, I'ma pitch it.